Bit tired today because didn't get to sleep as early as I wanted due to a moth getting in the bedroom.
Fuck me!
I got it in a glass and looked at it for a bit and then let it go because Suzanne wanted to go to sleep. Looked up some interesting news. Some people dug up an old body in Ireland. Turns out it's well old and was here when dinosaurs were here. The really weird bit is it had hair gel in its hair.
Right, what is it?
Fella.
Well, no, it wasn't around when dinosaurs were here then.
Just a bit after.
Right, fine. A lot after, yeah, go on. I think any hominid, anything that could even be linked to anything that may become man, is only about a million years old. And I think Homo sapien is probably only about 150,000 years old. Dinosaurs are about 150 million to 250 million.
Yeah, yeah, no, it's not the age bit, that's amazing. It's the fact of, there's a fella, won't have even had shoes on his feet.
Right.
And yet he was worried about his hairstyle.
Right, well that's definitely not true either. This is unbelievable.
Well, there was a man on the radio doing poetry, says Carl in his diary. I thought I'd have a go at doing a poem about today.
Not really. Steve, I'm a little bit queasy. He hasn't really written a poem.
He's written a small poem.
No, he hasn't really.
Yes. If moths had eyes...
Fuck me!
let me read the poem, okay?
Oh, fuck.
You wouldn't interrupt T.S. Eliot.
Okay. Okay.
If moths had eyes, would they be happier? How do they know they're not dead? Cavemen hunting for food, but not before they style the hair on their head. What would last longer in dinosaur times? A blind man didn't stand a chance. Not with all them rocks about. I'd rather be a blind moth.
Right! It may be the greatest poem
now,
ever written.
Just, you know, dissecting it briefly, you attempt to rhyme in the first four lines, but abandon the rhyming system in the last three. Is there a creative decision for that?
Can we have Carl read that?
By
sorry,
means, yeah.
just you read it as you would like to. So this is, imagine this, right, okay. This is going out all over the world, this podcast.
And now, Karl Pilkington, a new poet from Manchester, now living in London, England, would like to read a poem.
If moths had eyes, would they be happier? How do they know they're not dead? Cavemen hunting for food, but not before they style the hair on their head. What would last longer in dinosaur times? A blind man didn't stand a chance. Not with all them rocks about. I'd rather be a blind moth.
We had bacon and egg on toast. I'm eager to get through the brown sauce, as the bottle is too big to go in any cupboard, so it has to be left on the sideboard. So I had about four dollops of the stuff. I love that, because, you know, that made it into the diary. He's concerned about the fact that the brown sauce is too big, so he's rushing through it.
I know, but I'm just saying the kitchen isn't that big, and it looks messy when you leave stuff out, doesn't it? And we've got this giant brown sauce bottle, and I don't want to chuck it away, because that'd be a waste.
So you're having brown sauce and everything, your cornflakes,
yeah.
In your tea.
Yeah.
A wasp got in the flat. You know trouble's brewing. It was massive. The biggest wasp ever. Suzanne asked me to get it out, but I wanted to take a picture of it first. I was getting my phone ready when it flew at me. I reckon the sting on it could have killed a kitten.
So specific.
It ended up flying out the window on its own. Drama averted.
Oh, God.
We went out for tea. You're always in a cafe. That's what this diary. You spend so much time in a cafe. There were loads of flying ants. I kept kicking the table because I could feel them on my legs. I wouldn't be that jumpy normally, but I still had flashbacks of the giant wasp from the morning. Suzanne told me to stop being stupid because I was ruining her night out.
A night out in a cafe. Brilliant.
What was it, her birthday?
And flashbacks from an incident.
Yeah.
Like he's some sort of like war veteran. What is it? It's the wasp. It could have killed a kitten.
Bought some wallpaper. We got back and got on with it. The wall that we've papered before has got a big mirror under it. We papered on top of it again. I ended up reading my phrase book while Suzanne did the rest of the tidying up. Now what's your phrase book? This is just you trying to master English, is it?
It's just a book that tells you little sayings and how they came about.
An interesting phrase is potluck. It came about when all people ate is stews. They used to chuck all sorts of stuff into the stew. You stuck your spoon in and sometimes you got something nice like beef, or you could end up with a bit of frog. It's potluck.
Good time, eh?
That's what it said in the book, didn't it?
A bit of frog!
Got up and checked the wallpaper out. There are loads of air bumps and it's buckled on the joins. I wish we'd never done it. Suzanne said the washer was broke and it's out of its warranty. She called up the people who made it and they said it will cost £150 to fix. I don't know how they know that when they haven't even seen it. I want to smash it to bits and see what they can do for £150. So much anger.
I want to smash it to bits. That'd be great, wouldn't it? 150, you sure? Yeah, come round.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it's just like a cube that's been through one of those car crushers. Yeah. 150 quid, there's 150 quid, fix it.
I watched the news and calmed down a bit, because there was a story about some Siamese twins who are having an operation. They've got two heads, four arms, two legs, one liver. The doctor said they will have one leg each. I felt bad worrying about the washer when people have bigger problems like the Siamese twins. Ricky and Steve asked me to do a poem about one day a week, so I thought I'd do one today. I can't obviously do it justice, so I should let the master read it.
You've done another poem?
Yeah, you said, you know, just do one. If you have a day where you've had a lot of emotions.
Well, I loved the poem, and so did the listeners, and I knew they would, so if you can do that every week, that'd be a joy
for
me.
You can't force a poem, though.
No, I know.
So a diary's easy to do, because you just write down what you're doing.
But you've got to have some really meaty subject matter to be able to write a poem, Rick, as you'll discover.
I know.
Right, so, you know, you've heard what problems they had that day.
Go on, then.
Bubbled wallpaper. What a mess. Washer dry and knackered. What a mess. Siamese twins separated. One leg less.
There was an animal in the paper today that I've never before seen. Jesus. It's called an alpaca. They are gormless looking. The fellow who breeds them said they are easy to look after because they're used to harsh conditions because they normally live in the mountains. The problem with this is they will turn useless eventually, and then if we try to bung it back on the Andes, they won't like it. It's like how people win these live like a star for a week competitions. They're not good for anyone. Okay.
Do you know what I mean? If something's living somewhere,
but he's not going to send them back bung to it the back? Andes. He's presumably breeding them for something else.
Yeah, but say if eventually, you know, the world's getting busy, there's hardly any room, and we go, right, what can we shift here? What's getting in our way that we can shift? Well, those funny-looking things came from the Andes, bung them back. All right, then, let's put them back. And they go, oh, they don't like it. They're not surviving, they're dying out. Why did we bring them here? Oh, it was closer. Yeah, but look, we've died out now of the...
Sorry, this is an argument with yourself. This isn't happening. They're angry about it, like it just happened and you're sick of it. None of this has happened yet.
No, I'm just looking at how it will happen. Leave them where they were.
But you're getting angry about things that you're speculating on now. It's absurd, Carl. Not once have I read here about your anger about terrorism or international, you know, political injustice. Not once have you written about that, only about the fact we may send animals back to the Andes.
I know, but just because it just annoyed me, that's all. They brought them here, some fella's getting a load of praise because they brought this weird animal into the country, and yet it's like, well, they were on the Andes for a reason. Leave them there. It was happier there. I mean, I feel guilty when I open a bag and a fly flies out of it, and I think, where's that come from?
What bag are you opening with bat flies? What bag?
No, just when, like, you know, the bag I took the computer home in, a fly flew out of it, and I thought, when did that get in that bag? Wherever brought that from? And it's the same thing. It doesn't want to be somewhere else. It was where it was. And that's the same with this placo, or whatever.
It's amazing! It really is the ramblings of a madman, isn't it?
Some new sea thing has been found.
There's no headlines on the news!
It wasn't found by sea experts, it was found on eBay. Someone was selling it for a fiver. I don't see the point in buying something that you don't know what it is.
What do you mean? It was...
Someone's found some sort of shell with a thing living in it.
Right.
They thought, oh, I've never seen one of these before, I can flog it on eBay. Someone bought it and then wanted to look after it, went to some sea expert and they said, oh, I don't know what that is. That's the story. It's just weird how stuff's being found on eBay.
No, it wasn't found on eBay though, was it?
Yeah, but that's where the specialist people sort of picked up on it. It's just weird that, I mean, all I was saying is I wouldn't want one. If you don't know how to, if it's a new creature, you don't know what makes it happy. When you get a kitten, you go, stroke its head, loves it, right? And you can do that knowing that it's liking it. If I had a little seashell and you go, does it sit in water? I don't know. Do you know what I mean? You could end up doing more damage. So that's why I wouldn't want it. It's nice to have rules, isn't it? It's nice to know what you're doing with something.
Well, as you write in the diary, it's like if an alien landed and wanted to live with you. As much fun as it might sound, it wouldn't be long before you got annoyed with it because it wouldn't eat the food you gave it.
That's what I'm saying, but I couldn't have a go at it because it might not like pasta.
It might not.
Spoke to Ricky and his friend Glyn about art. I just don't get it. Ricky had some odd pictures on his walls. I don't have any pictures up in my flat because of the mirrored wall. But I can't say I'm bothered. The mirrored wall, we should just explain what that is. When you moved into your flat, there was an enormous mirror on one wall, was that right?
We just got this flat and, you know, it's not a big flat, so I think the people who had it before us, he was a gay fella, right, which was a bit like, oh, what's he been doing with that mirror and that? But
what?
No, just, you know. Just,
what? What? What has he been doing with the mirror?
Well, what's he been doing? Why? It's just because they're quite sort of experimental in it, aren't they? And
I don't know, what do you mean? What do they do?
Well, I wouldn't know anything about it, but go on.
No, what do you want?
No, I don't.
Experimental
what
do in what way?
What do you mean experimental?
I just mean, you know, they'd be doing stuff.
What? What?
Whatever they do.
Chemistry, have a chemistry set out, they'd be doing experiments, what?
No, just doing what?
Singing I Am What I Am and just checking out their,
no, each
their dance
their
moves.
I'm not having a go at anyone, but what? I'm just saying, like, they're doing what they're doing, which
Carl, you're
is
not
annoying
phone
as well.
You?
No, I'm not. This is what, why, well, but,
what? Why are you worried about what a little gay fella was doing in your flat before you got it in front of a mirror?
I wasn't worried about it.
Why are you thinking about what he's doing? Why are you fantasising what a little gay fella was doing in front of your mirror in your...
I'm not bothered. I'm just telling you what why it was a bit odd that he had a mirror in there, right? But forget the history.
But you've got a mirror in there now, haven't you?
No, because what I did was, I was going to take it down, and I thought, oh, it's a bit dangerous. This, you know, it could crack and...
Because it's the size of the whole wall, isn't it?
It took up a whole wall.
Right.
So, like, when he's moving about everywhere, he's got a good view of it and that. But he's got this full wall of mirror, and I thought, I can't take that down. And, I thought, what can I do? So I've just put wallpaper on it.
Brilliant.
And it looks all right, you wouldn't know, what have you. But it means that I can't put any pictures up. That's all I'm saying. Because if I put a nail in it...
And what don't you understand about art? What about art don't you understand? The concept? Specifics?
Just, the way some people like, you know, the ones you've got, where it's just like a block of colour on a bit of canvas. It's like, what's that?
Abstract. It's just abstract. It's you know, it's a vibrancy of colour. It's a, you know, an attack on the senses. Or it could be, there could be something in there that you might see. You might not see first time round, or it could be, you know.
Yeah, but there's loads of stuff to look at without having to do that.
But
you've got
the
windows.
Point
I can understand if you had a cell, and there's no windows and you want a bit of colour. But you've got a window to look out of, and you've got, like, just a big block of...
But I was explaining this to you, that the photograph, where people, before, you know, the art was photography, it was realistic, and, you know, they had to make it look like the subject. But then, when cameras came in, that's when people started doing surreal stuff. And
I understand that.
Otherwise, there was no point to it. They had to find a new way to represent things that photography couldn't do as such.
No, so, that's like when we were in London having a shop around at Christmas and there was that picture of fruit for 700 quid. It's like, well, just get some fruit, you know what I mean? You can get some real fruit for 3 quid.
Yeah.
I understand that, but there's nothing wrong with, like, having a... We'll get... Don't invent cameras, then, one or the other. Do you know what I mean? That's what annoys me. Someone invents something, and then they go, we've got to invent something else. Like the abstract thing. Why has someone gone, oh, I can't have paintings anymore because...
What is it, a Dali? Going mounting clocks and stuff. Right?
I mean, the first one was all right when he did the first clock, but then all the time he's just like, oh, I'll draw something and it's got a melting clock on it. Mm. I'll do a sheep, put one of them on it.
Have you seen his lobster telephone?
That annoys me.
Why?
Because he's not. I mean, what annoyed me more with that is when he heard about how it happened. He had some artist mate round, right, and. I don't know what happened.
That's a good hell of an anecdote.
No, but they were eating. They were eating some food and what have you.
Yeah. Lobsters?
And, yeah, they were eating lobster.
Oh, right.
And,
that's Andy.
I don't know, the other artist, whoever it was, sort
telephone.
Of started saying, oh, you and your clocks and all that, right?
Brilliant.
And, They started arguing.
Yeah.
And he chucked some of the lobster.
Bollocks.
And it landed on the phone. It bounced off his mate's head, went on the phone, and they both looked at each other like, are you thinking what I'm thinking? And they brought out that phone as a bit of art. Things like that annoy me. Because it was them just messing about.
That didn't happen.
Just telling you what I know. I saw his work. Each to their own, if that's what he's doing. I'm just saying, I'm not putting my stamp of approval on it.
Heaven forbid. Well, you know, as you mentioned in your diary, your favourite artist is Lowry. Because you can look at them for ages and see someone different every time you look at it.
All I'm saying is, art should be there to tell a story, not just to have a splash of colour. We know colours out there, there's loads of colour. We don't need to be reminded of it.
But colour's part of our evolution, and so it does something to us. Just like sounds, just like sounds.
Yeah, but I'm saying do a picture.
Smells.
Colour it in. Still use the colours, but draw something with it rather than just going a bit of yellow, a bit of red. Like that one you've got, just red and black. What's that meant to do?
Well, it does something.
What?
Well, I like it. I enjoy it, so it does something.
You have it, then. I'm just saying, I prefer it if it was something.
And so you, and what, let me just get straight, you had a mirror on one wall, so you padded that wall.
It's just
and
sort
you've
of,
padded
it's
the just, others.
It's just sort of, wallpaper on it.
Right.
Amazing.
And there's no other art in there, it's just an empty cell.
Well, Suzanne likes some art, just like, Suzanne's not allowed to watch telly unless it's a favourite thing, otherwise she's got to talk to me about stuff. There's no art, there's no point, just wallpaper.
I'm just saying, we've got three windows we can look out of.
Right.
Right? Stop looking at the walls, look out the window.
Some new words have been introduced into the dictionary. Too many words. We should have some system where we can get rid of words if they aren't used a certain number of times.
Well, that we do.
They do die out, don't they, eventually?
Like what?
You don't have to use them.
No, but they don't, do they? They keep adding them. And I just worry about, you know, this is the problem with, like, your head can only hold so much, can't it?
Yeah.
It all very well when Adam and Eve was knocking about. There's no history, they don't have to remember anything. All I'm saying is, fine, bring out a new word, but once you bring out a new one, bin another one. The dictionary is getting bigger and bigger. No one's keeping an eye on it.
Well, I think they are.
They're not. They keep adding.
It doesn't grow. They don't just dig it up one day. So, it's got bigger. What have you done?
So
left it out.
You're happy for them to stick in iPod, let's say.
But we can pride ourselves on having more words in English language than any other language. I think we've got twice as many as the second. I think maybe Russian. I'm not sure about that. I saw someone email us, but.
But we don't talk the most, so there's a lot of clutter there.
What do you mean we don't talk the most?
Well, you'd
say
that.
Nothing as expressive as the English language.
Yeah, no, because we've got a word for everything. I'm just saying that I don't use all these words that are coming out, and I just think, like I say, keep an eye on it. Some sort of, I don't know how it can be controlled.
But Shakespeare invented words. I think Shakespeare invented about 1,200 words.
Yeah, and we're probably still using a lot of his. So why do we keep sticking more in the pot?
Right.
Stop using loads of words.
People are panicking in New York about the snow they're getting. It's 2 foot deep. They're saying it's to do with global warming. I don't get it. 2 days ago, they were saying the world's getting warmer and the ice is melting on one of the poles where the polar bears are. As long as we get snow on the world, does it matter where it goes? Read on the internet that heads are bigger now than they were years ago. Brains are getting bigger, apparently. This is because we're being told too much information. We are told too much stuff about things that we wouldn't have known about years ago. You've just made that leap, haven't you? Presume maybe heads and brains are getting larger, but the fact that it's because there's too much information cramming in them.
As time goes on, isn't it? It's that thing of we're being taught more and more every day. As the time goes on, something's happening every day. You've got to remember that.
No, you haven't.
You have. It's the same. Like I said, you know, with the Adam and Eve thing, they didn't have that much to remember. They come on the world. They go. What happened yesterday? Oh, not much.
Me mam phoned and said that me auntie Nora, the classic auntie Nora, wanted me to look on the internet to find out what the weather will be like in Spain at the end of November. I don't know where she gets her money from. 2 months ago, she was asking me, Dad, how much it would be to get her back garden astroturfed, because she's sick and tired of the grass getting out of her.
What does she want to do? Start a football team? What does she want a back garden astroturfed?
She likes the sort of green look, but she doesn't like the headache that comes with it, so she's just looking into getting that false grass put in there.
Brilliant.
Don't know how much it is. But.
Went round to Ricky's and had some chicken curry that Ricky's girlfriend Jane had made. Ricky and Jane were going on holiday for a few days and had arranged for Glyn to come in and make sure the cat was okay while they were away. I'm sick of that cat. I was surprised that they hadn't paid for the little shit to go away with them on first class. Blimey, getting a bit vitriolic in the
Why doesn't he like the fact that I've got a cat and I love the cat? Why?
It's just everything in that house that you've got gets sort of special treatment, and it's a cat and it
What do you mean you get
me?
Special treatment?
Sometimes
we put food down for it, and sometimes it gets on our lap, and we stroke it.
You don't just stroke it. We're not sending it. You massage its back. You go, no, you stressed out.
Well, no, it's good. I'm not saying you stressed out. At no point did I say you stressed out. You said, what the fuck are you doing for? Is it stressed out or something? I like touching my cat.
To be honest with you, I don't like Ricky's cat.
I can't believe
because
it!
Because every time I go around there, it goes straight from the ghoulies.
Yeah,
instantly.
He'd probably seen you in the sea and thought, well, if he's waving it about, I'll have a bit of that.
But it's like the lizard thing you've got. It's just sat there, you've bought it a big box, right, to be in.
Right, it's a salamander, right. So it's an amphibian. Yeah. It's not a box, it's a big vivarium.
Yeah, but what I'm saying
is... And if you're going to criticise someone for just sitting there, having a round head and doing nothing with its life, people who live in glass houses, no, we've done this one.
Do you know what gets me, though, right, Steve? When I was there, I was looking at it, and I thought, is it dead, right? Because he's just sat there, like...
And then it was thinking exactly the same fucking thing.
He sat there, not moving, right? And then, on the top of the box, is like a box full of crickets and stuff. That's... It's food.
Yeah.
Right? But they were more active than the thing that it was going to feed. Get rid of the lizard. Keep them in there. More entertaining. Don't understand it.
A few months back, a girl who was having a kid showed me one of them scans of the kid that was in her. That's science gone mad, innit? I couldn't think of anything nice to say, as it looked like a frog.
Do you know why we've got to that point?
What?
Why have we got to see something that young? Why?
Because people can keep an eye on the progress of the baby in the womb.
Yeah, but why are they printing it out and stuff? Surely that's for a doctor to see.
Well, that's just an added bonus for people who are interested in such things.
That's like saying, why do you take pictures of anything?
No, because normally pictures are like, you know, you in Brazil, sat in the sea or whatever. You'd go, oh yeah, I remember that day, it was a good day or whatever. But...
It wasn't.
It's just kind of like, why have you got to see something... You might as well.
Why have you got to see something that small? So why would you take a picture of Steve in the sea?
No, but what I mean is, why? At what point are we going to stop? Are we going to start sort of X-raying the fella's testicles and saying, well, there it is at a really young age? Well, where are we going
to
stop?
It's just horses for courses, isn't it? Some people like to have a record of their baby in the womb. They like to show the baby. They're excited about it.
They sit down and they show the friends the slideshow. That's the birth. Oh, that's the conception. Oh, look, Ron's going a bit mad there, isn't he?
But why do I need to see this? This is what I'm saying. It was an awkward situation because she was happy with it. I was like, oh, God. You know what I mean? It was an odd-looking thing. I couldn't say, oh, it looks like you, because that would be a diss.
Met Suzanne at Euston Station. I said I would sort out the tea tonight, so I called the curry house. The fella couldn't understand me. I asked for 2 poppadoms. He kept saying, how many? I kept saying 2. He still couldn't understand. I said, 1 more than 1. He understood. When we picked up the food and took it home, there were 5 poppadoms in the bag.
Oh, God! Oh, God.
There is a restaurant somewhere that sells knobs to eat.
No, there's not.
There is.
No, there's not.
No, there is.
It says that women can't eat too many of them, and if you want a seal's knob for dinner, you have to book in advance.
Right, it's gobbledygook. This is the ramblings of a madman again.
It's a trend, he writes. It won't last long. It'll be like hummus.
But hummus, when did that happen?
What do you mean it's still going? It's a Greek traditional food.
I know, but there's one there's a restaurant down the road that's all they do. That isn't a proper meal, that's a side order, isn't it? That's like having a restaurant just flogging tomato ketchup. hummus isn't a meal. They don't even try and kid you and get you in and slug you just hummus. They could actually say it's hummus today. Not gonna work, be shut down within a month.
Called Ricky and asked what the difference is between the mind and the brain.
Yeah, he
That's
did.
A hell of a phone call.
Yeah,
again.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Ricky did explain, but I can't remember what he said. I wondered at what age you are when the mind kicks in. Okay. Ricky changed the subject and said there is an island called Spider Island. There's nothing but spiders on it. A bloke went to visit the island and said there was 1,000 types of spider in one tree.
Yeah. Excited I didn't tell you that.
No, I locked it up after talking to you.
Oh, right. Is that true?
Yeah, they just said there's loads of them.
What do you think about that? What do you think about an island that's just full of spiders?
It's a bit daft, isn't it?
What do you think they should do then?
I don't know, because you need spiders. I don't know what they do, but they say a world without spiders, like, wouldn't be good.
Who says that?
I don't know, someone. But they sort of do something. There's something about if you did get rid of them all, it would have an effect.
Well, of course it would. Get rid of anything, it would have an effect.
Not everything, though. Like I've said, you know, jellyfish and what have you.
Well, no.
The world wouldn't change.
Well, it would.
No, it wouldn't.
Well, it would, because it's part of an ecosystem, so they're some things food, aren't they?
No, but it's 97% water or something.
Yeah.
So how much are they doing? Just give them another 3%, make them water. And that's more useful.
Give them another 3% and make them water! Oh, God.
The rain ain't stopped. The old woman with the bent neck. Now, we've not heard about the old woman with the bent neck before.
She's a whole new character. Who's this? Incredible.
She's really old.
And she's got a bent neck, yeah, but tell us something else.
I don't know what's up with her, but her head sort of comes out of here.
No, it's radio. They can't see what you're doing.
It sort of comes out of a chest. So from behind, it looks like she hasn't got an head. It's really weird, right? I mean, she's old, and I don't know what's happened. Just Suzanne said it's sad, and her bones have sort of bent up or something, or maybe she carried something heavy when she was younger.
On her head.
And, you know, I don't know, it's sad and everything.
Yeah.
But she's just, she's wandering up and down the street, always looks fed up, but you can see her, you have to sort of bend down a little bit.
Mm.
But her head's just, I thought I'd told you about
it. She finds a lot of change.
Yeah. I said, yeah.
Well, as you write in the diary, the old woman with the bent neck is struggling in the weather. The rain must be running down her back. Don't know why she went out in this weather. Me back's doing me head in today. It does this every time the weather turns a bit grim, ever since I tried to kick me height. Oh, remember that? We've heard this before. Kicked me height and landed on me arse. Was going to treat Suzanne to a trip to the pictures to see Breakback Mountain, but then remembered there is a programme on about two-headed kid tonight. A band from the Conga have won the best newcomers in a Radio 3 competition. They use pots and pans for instruments. It says that the Conga is a poor, sad place. So why do people do that happy dance at the end of parties called the Conga?
Right. One, it's the Congo. There's no place called the Conga. They come from a place called the Congo. Where do you come from? Okie-kokie. It's a terrible place that we don't know whether we'll put our left leg in or our right leg in. Sometimes we shake it all about.
We're not sure if we should.
But, Conga! Fucking hell, you're such a...
Went into the gadget shop today. It's full of stuff that we don't need. Gadget used to be a good word that made you think of James Bond with all his gadgets. The best thing I could find in the shop was a clock that ran on potatoes. We are definitely going backwards.
I agree. Well, who cares about that? A little electrical impulse, so what?
Had a night out with old schoolmate. Found out about more of the other lads I went to school with. One is living underground.
What do you mean living underground? Not like a mole. Do you mean he's got a basement, or do you mean he digs a hole every night?
My mate went to visit him and he said it had been raining really heavily and that, and it's all the rain's running in.
What do you mean he went to visit him? He went down here? What's that? That's an hole in the ground. Yeah, come in.
He just said, oh, come round see us, and he's living underground.
What do you mean he's living underground?
He wanted to be in the army but was turned away, and that's the closest thing you can sort of...
How is that similar to the army?
Oh, that's exactly like the army, yeah, yeah, where they teach you trades and, you know, engineering and flying.
He's happy down there. He said it was really muddy and what have you, so he won't be going back to visit him.
What's he got down there?
Just stuff, just like a sleeping bag, a lamp.
He's dug himself a subterranean cave.
Near my old infant school, they knocked it down because it was like a wreck. You'd be in the class and you could lean on the wall.
Yeah,
and
subsidence.
Your arm would go through it and stuff. And they knocked it all down, and I think that's when he was at his most happy, this bloke.
I believe this, though. I believe someone he went to school with now lives in a hole. That doesn't shock me. When the tales I've heard of horses in houses and big-headed kids with webbed hands and feet, and him, I believe that someone he went to school with now lives in a hole. That isn't bizarre to me. That's
you spent far too long with him, if that, now you're just happy to accept.
I totally accept that. I'd be surprised if I walked round where he lived that there weren't more people living in holes. His dad wanted to throw his budgie on the fire.
True.
His budgie died, his dad said, let's throw it on the fire. I mean, his mum, what did your mum do when your budgie died?
She just was worried about the other bird that was left, so she made it a bit of company by getting a rock, getting a feather off the dead budgie, sticking it on the rock, putting it in the cage.
So, a man living in a hole is not that bizarre. Right, carry on.
I read me science magazine. Some things I learnt from the science magazine. Number one, space is running out of space. We should stay out of the sea, cos shark attacks are up.
Yeah. Probably 4 a year now.
Well, he just says here, we should just stop going in the sea.
Yeah.
There's no need for it.
Exactly.
Why is there no need for going in the sea?
Just cos there isn't now, is there? We've got loads of land. So just, you know, one or the other. We walked out of the sea. Now, this is what I mean about going backwards. Getting back in it again. We came from the sea originally, now we're going back in it. Don't go in it. Unless you're in a boat.
Rules! The rules, according to Karl Pilkington!
The rules of Karl Pilkington.
Oh, God!
Did the podcast and then went for a walk round Manchester Square. Years ago, a woman lived round there who had a head like a pig. She was known as the Pig Woman of Manchester Square. That made me think if there were other pig-headed women knocking about London.
Do you know what I mean? Why was she nicknamed that? Why not just the pig-headed woman? That suggests to me like there was loads of pig-headed women and that's the one of Manchester Square.
Right.
Well, no, it was more to do with identifying her, not amongst other pig-headed women, but go, have you seen the pig woman of Manchester Square? I.e., go down there and see the pig woman, it's in Manchester Square.
What happens if she's walked off from there, though, and you go, well, no, but I saw one on New Cavendish Street.
No, she'll always come back if you rattle the feed.
Watched a film about Hitler. Didn't watch all of it, as it was subtitled. Can't be doing with that. Asked Suzanne if cinemas are full of deaf people when they're showing subtitled films. She said, shh, I'm trying to watch it. I said, what do you mean, shh? It's subtitled, I can make as much noise as I want.
Yeah.
She's a lucky, lucky woman.
You must be a joy to watch a subtitled film. I mean, the concentration is up there already. I mean, it is hard to concentrate. It's not as easy as when you're hearing it, because, you know, you read things, but, you know, it's possible. If you had a buffoon going, I'm just going to sit here and make as much noise as I want, what's the point of that?
Yeah.
What is the point of that? I mean, it's possible, but why do that in a cinema? Just walk into a subtitle film and go, right, everybody, let's all do the conga.
Well, yeah, or during ballet, you know, I mean, ballet, they're just dancing, you don't need to listen to the words, just have a conversation. We're having our bathroom done. The bathroom man was around at 9 this morning. We weren't allowed to use the shower because it all had to be bone dry before we could use his waterproof filler. Not that waterproof, then. Went for a brew with Ricky. We talked about monkeys and how they are closer to humans than they are to apes, and how bees will drink cider to get off their heads. Now and again, there is a bee that lets the drinking get in the way of the work, and other bees sting it to death. Blimey.
Yeah, well, there's bees. They love a drink. They will drink pure alcohol. They drink 100%, they drink ethanol. You know, I don't know why. They love getting off it and they fall down and they're drunk, right? A bee can take in the equivalent of like 20 litres of wine, right? But some bees get addicted in the same sort of percentage as human addiction, like 10% of bees, they can't get enough of it. They take ethanol, they take cider, apples and that. And then when they get back to the hive, they go in a bit pissed and they've got guard bees and they go, come on, we've all had a drink.
Bouncers.
Yeah. They sort of are, right? And they push them away and push them away again. Then the next time they go, right, I've had enough. And they give it a good hiding. And Karl couldn't get over this. I saw his face, but I knew that he was thinking of that bee with sort of like eyes rolling round his head, a little bit belligerent with his jacket on backwards.
Yeah.
You know, and the bouncer going, come on, come on, son, we've all had enough, let's move away, yeah. Move away.
You're not coming in, right? You're wearing trainers.
Yeah, you know, you're wearing three pairs of trainers I'm sick of it, you know.
But what I did find out, because I went home and went on the computer trying to find out about drunk bees knocking about, They're not actually meant to fly. It's only because they don't know. Well, no, but they're if they were told that you're not actually designed to fly, they wouldn't bother.
No, this is that thing that goes around that aerodynamically, on the face of it, looking at the size of the wings and the body proportions and everything, that it's a surprise that they can fly. Okay, it's not that. No one's ever told them they can't, and as soon as someone tells them you're not meant to fly, they all fall out of the sky going, oh, what are we doing? Like in a cartoon.
No, but it's something about the confidence and that. At the moment, nobody's saying
to
them.
It's nothing to do with the confidence. There is no such thing as confidence in bees. A bee never loses his nerve. That's not why he drinks. Because what are you drinking for? I'm just not confident anymore. There's no point to turn to the bottle. I can't go up there again. You're an idiot.
Suzanne said today can be my day because she has been a bit of a pain with her illness and that. So she said I can do what I want today. We went for a walk around Green Park. Loads of tourists were about looking at the Queen's house. She was in because the flag was up. I wouldn't want to live there. Why wouldn't you want to live there? Just because it's right in the centre of town.
It's just not in a good place, is it? It's got a roundabout outside and that.
Really busy.
It's pretty good.
I went for a pee in the toilets. When I came out, a pigeon had shat on Suzanne's coat. She was in a bit of a mood about it. A bird shat on my ear once. I left it for about 10 to 15 minutes until I got home. I washed it off, and in that 10 to 15 minutes, it had corroded me ear.
Yeah, but he's had a lot of problem with ears. He told me the other day, he got up, washed, had a bath, had some breakfast, went to the shops to get a newspaper and, well, had a chat with a woman in the corner shop, got home, pottering around, looked in the mirror, he had a cotton bud sticking out of his ear. He went, what annoyed me was she didn't say anything. Like it's her responsibility.
Yeah.
No, but she knows me well enough to sort of, you know, go, you know you got a cotton bud in your ear.
No, she knows you well enough to go, Carl's got a cotton bud in his ear, I've seen worse. When you've got a cotton bud in your ear, what interrupted you?
I think Suzanne called or my dad called or something, and then because I was running a little bit late because I've been talking to them, the earbud was in, I just popped my coat on and went to the shop.
Carl, you got a toothbrush in your mouth. Oh.
Walked through Covent Garden. There were five of them mimes knocking about. I don't understand why people take pictures of mimes. Everyone looks like a mime in a picture.
That's so true. That's really true. If the point is they're staying still, if that's their skill, a picture won't tell that story. That's absolutely true.
My dad took the cat to be put down today because it kept bumping into things since losing its sight. My mam said she's not going to get another one. She said the parrot is looking worried as it's seen the budgie and the cat go in the space of 3 months.
Your mum said the parrot's looking worried. What's the what happened to the cat then?
It gets into a lot of fights. It lost one eye, and then it got into another fight and lost another.
Oh,
and it was just walking around bumping into stuff. The vet sort of said, oh, we can do stuff to keep it alive and all that, but it's a bit out of order, isn't it? Because it costs a fortune, they shouldn't tell you.
But
Mum and Dad can't afford to have eyes put on it and stuff.
No, you can't have eyes put on a cat anyway.
No, but they said, oh, we can do something here. We can have its eyes sorted out.
But I don't think you should be allowed cats.
Why?
Not the Pilkington family.
Why not? Well, they have good lives. Yeah, I know, but they have good lives whilst they're still knocking about. It's just that we get through them.
It's a good job you're not going to have kids.
Oh, God almighty. I can't believe it. The cat that kept throwing up. So his mum shaved it. Unbelievable. Dry wipe cat.
A mate sent me a story on email about a bloke in China who has this weird illness that means he can't have his picture taken. That's not the weird bit. If he tries, his body doesn't appear in the photo.
Don't talk shit.
He has had group pictures taken and everyone appeared apart from him.
Don't talk shit.
The story had a picture next to it of a family photo and it said he was stood at the back, but you couldn't see him.
Right. He wasn't in the picture.
He was in the picture.
No, he wasn't in the picture.
He's done loads of tests and stuff.
No, I haven't done loads of tests. This is bollocks. There's no way this is scientifically possible. Now he's wanted. Just a white bit of paper up on the police wall. Have you seen this man? What man? If you see him, tell us. You're talking shit.
Suzanne watched the film You've Got Mail tonight for about the 14th time. I don't think you could properly fancy someone without seeing them. Unless you're blind. I think it's odd when blind people have affairs. Why is that odd?
Just because most stuff is based on looks, isn't it? So you think once they've found someone, they're happy with them. Stick with them.
But no, it's not true. No, but I mean, most things are based on looks.
What I mean is when you first meet someone and that.
Well, then initially it's only looks because you don't know them.
So that's what I'm saying.
But that's a ridiculous thing to say, isn't it?
Well, no, it's just what I think. I'm not saying that's like fact or anything. I'm just thinking if you're blind, why mess about?
You're still basing on it if it's only looks that people find what?
Yeah, I'm just saying. So why is a blind person messing about having an affair?
Because I'm saying that. Presumably that blind person isn't basing anything on looks.
I just, all right, I mean, maybe that's not, I mean more like-
Do you want me to cross it out? Shall I cross it out? Because well, it's
just the same way, I think I put how, you know, people, I read something in a Sunday paper once with some bloke who was going out with some woman, he ended up going out with a sister who was a twin. If you're going to have a change, have a change.
Spoke to Ricky about trips to the moon. Ugh. He was up for going just to see what the world looks like. I came up with the idea of a giant mirror on the moon that would reflect the world back. He had a few questions, but I had the answers.
Yeah.
He changed the subject, I won.
Right. My first question was, how would you get it up there? He said, bit by bit. That'd be a good mirror then, wouldn't it? I said, how big would it be? He went, you'd still need a telescope. I said, how would you get it on the right side of the moon, always facing the right? He went, what? He went, does the moon move then? I went, yes.
And if we don't like the mirror on the moon, we can always wallpaper over it. Got up and put the radio on. I listened to the story that the vicar read on Radio 2.
Yeah, that could be good.
He was saying how Jesus was 33 when he died. He said he was more into the idea of doing a lot in your life than living for ages. This was linked to the news about the doctor who's come up with some stuff that he's been injecting himself and his wife with that makes you age better. I looked it up on the internet. It wasn't worth them doing it because they are already old looking. I don't know why people want to stay looking young. You can wear a bald head better if you're old because hairs are replaced by wrinkles.
It's drivel.
No, it's not drivel.
A pointless entry to a diary, that.
It's not, because that could be like an important bit in like world history.
What?
The fact that someone's trying to make people not age. Age is good, isn't it? When you see an old person.
That's been going forever.
What has?
People trying to age better.
No, but he's talking about if you're 90, he wants people to look like they're 30. And that's not good, because how would the world run when that's going on?
Well, I agree. But you know, it's not a revelation.
If I like chatting to old people, because they know a lot of stuff. So if I'm sat on a train and someone's old, I'm happier talking to them about.
They get up and move after about 10 minutes.
Well, no, the fact that many of them are infirm and can't.
Yeah, they have to stay there and listen to this one.
But yeah, even that means that they're getting more out of life in a way, because they don't move about as much, so they have more thinking time. It is weird how that happens to you as you get closer to death.
Jesus.
You know, you're not working as much because you're resting, and you can think back about your life, and you can think, oh, I had a good one. Actually, it's not been that bad. Whereas if.
But you must have started that now. Because you've been doing nothing for the past 3 months.
Yeah, but I'm just, well, like I'm saying, it is a good thing for you to do, to sort of think about what you've been doing with your days and your weeks.
And how do you assess your life so far? With all this spare time you've had in your hands and moping around and moaning about your illness and just sitting around, right? You've been introspecting, have you?
Yeah.
Go on then. What have you come up with?
I haven't come up with anything. I'm just, you know, I have an all right life and things are changing.
Ugh. Keep saying that.
No, but you don't know how much they are changing. To the point of, I don't know if I mentioned the squirrel eating Mars bars, but from that, from that happening, to monkeys opening bottles with lids on them, to, it's mental out there. It's madness what is going on. And all I'm saying is old people need to be old people. You need oldness. You need to see old people. You need to go, right, they might have a solution, they've been on the earth longer. Quick, we need an answer. How old are you? I'm 32, well you look 78.
I don't know what you're saying!
I don't know who that conversation was with, why you got angry, and I think you made the opposite point that you were making at the beginning. If you say you're 32, you look 78. No, you were saying about it would be a problem if you were 78 and looked 32. Well, I don't know what you're saying. You came down on the wrong side then. Either. You did that whole thing and you bollocksed it up again in your brain.
I'm just saying, either way, you need to have people who look old. Otherwise, who's in charge?
I don't know what you mean. Right. So you say even if so, you're saying it'd be all right to make 78-year-olds look 32 as long as there were some 32-year-olds that looked 78. As long as you've got old-looking people.
No, but say.
Can
like,
I tear this page out? Because it's worthless.
What I mean is, when I went to the doctors, I saw the specialist. Right, about the kidney stones. I was asking him all the straight questions.
Go on.
Is it life-threatening?
No.
You know, how long am I going to be out?
Couple of days.
Right now.
As it turned out, it is life-threatening, and you've been out for 3 months whinging about the fucking thing. Strange.
Now, he was quite old. He looked about 55, and that reassured me in a way. In a way, it didn't, because he's one of them doctors who didn't open his eyes much, and I kind of thought, I hope you
open them wider. I don't know what you're talking about. What do you mean?
What?
What do you mean he didn't open his eyes much?
One of those sort of doctors who's either that overworked that he does that, you know, when he's like, he's tired, so he's going, right, what we're going to do is, and he's doing that with his eyes shut, he's talking like that.
This is radio.
I know, but I'm telling you, so you can see.
But people are meant to be listening to this.
But if they can't imagine me with my eyes shut.
Well, tell them you got your eyes shut. Just say he had his eyes shut.
Yeah, he had his eyes shut.
Oh, had he been reading this? Bored stupid, I imagine. He's just trying to get a...
Well, do you know what I mean? Or I don't know if it's because he's tired or if he's that educated that some people know so much you don't even have to look at it.
You don't know what you're talking about!
Intelligent people.
Who is so educated that they don't need to open their eyes?
You see it, you see like...
Who's that bloke of those? Is he blind? No, he's been reading too much. He doesn't open his eyes anymore, doesn't he? No.
Old people who you see wearing tweed and what have you, and they're really posh and they talk, and whenever they talk their eyes are shut and they
open... I don't know what this observation is.
I don't understand why you've never seen that.
I've never seen an old, educated man wearing tweed who doesn't bother open his fucking eyes.
Steve, I don't know
what you're talking about.
Steve, have you seen... Do you know what I mean? When people don't sort of open their eyes when they're talking to you, and it can be quite annoying, because it's like they're saying, I'm not interested about you sat there, I'm not bothered if you're listening or not, I'm saying what I'm saying because I say what I say.
But if he has got his eyes closed, he's probably just trying to absorb what you're saying and think carefully about it, so
anyway,
he doesn't misdiagnose
you. I'm not having a go at him.
Well,
I'm just saying he was 50-odd, and I was happy that he was there telling me...
I don't know why you were watching his eyes when he was telling you about your insides.
Because you can tell a lot by people's eyes. That's what I said about jellyfish. But, you know, just lines in a face tell a few stories, and I don't think we should get rid of them lines.
Looks like the world's fattest man is having an operation to get rid of some of the fat.
Yeah.
He has to have an iron bed because that's the only thing that can hold his weight. Yeah. There's also a man whose skull has fell out. He's in hospital somewhere. I hate that. It would make me panic. The hospital is busy with people coming in to look at their head.
What are you talking about there? That tells us nothing. Right, it's impossible for a skull to fall out.
How are scholars in 10,000 years going to be... What are they going to decipher from that?
They can sort of go...
There's not enough incident detail.
But how did his skull fall out?
Circulation problems.
But answer the question, how did his skull fall out? Fall out of what?
He was at home, and I don't know if he was combing his hair or something, but it come off.
What did?
His skull.
What do you mean, his skull? Do you know what the skull is?
It's a part of the head.
Well, no, it's the structure of the head, it's the bone. Do you mean the top of the skull?
This is only useful if you have all the salient facts. Then it would be of interest to us. We could.
Well, that I couldn't take that on. I'm busy. I'm not going to start looking into stuff in depth. Just get the details.
Oh, God. You're such an idiot. You are the best, idiot in the world.
Well, I don't want to be premature, but that entry is followed by, I injured my toe the other day by dropping the toaster. Instead of letting it hit the floor, I tried to catch it with my foot. I didn't think I'd done any harm, but my nail looks like it could fall off. I might show it to the doctor when I get me kidney stones out. We could easily get by without nails on the feet. They are more trouble than there were.
You're so wrong. You're so wrong.
I think on the days when cavemen without shoes and animals need nails, I don't think we need them now. I honestly... Because you hear about ingrowing toenails... Right, so that's a problem. You've got to cut them. stuff gets under there and gets infected. Get rid of them, you won't have any of that. As long as you wear shoes.
No, you'd have unprotected toes and fingers, wouldn't you?
I didn't say on the fingers, just on the toes.
So why do you need them on the fingers and not the toes?
Because you use your hands to do stuff. I've said about toenail out, it'd be good to have it growing on the head.
What?
Just having like a sheet of it, just like a nail on the forehead. You wouldn't look weird because we'd all have it. I'm not saying.
What are you talking about now?
I'm just saying I don't want to go on about evolution and stuff because we've done it all.
What do you think the skull is for?
No, but I mean on the outside, so that when you bang your head, it's a little bit more protection. Like people, I mean, you're looking at me like that. Why do you wear a helmet on a bike then?
Because the bike wasn't meant to be invented. We weren't meant to whiz along at 70 miles an hour with evolution.
I know, but because life's changing, like you've said. Let's
but you can't you can't go, let's evolve, let's re-evolve.
Okay, let's assume we've got this nail on our head that's growing out of our forehead.
So we look like one big thumb.
Yeah. Which weirdly, Carl, kind of, I mean, you can almost imagine it looking at Carl now. You can imagine a big nail there. Does the nail continue to grow? Do we have to trim the head nail?
Yeah, in the same way you get a haircut.
Why is that preferable in your mind to just wearing a crash helmet in instances where you might have something hit your head?
Just because, for a start, helmets, you have to carry them around with you. That's one thing that's put me off having a motorbike. Whenever you see someone on a motorbike, it's all like the clothes you've got to wear. And it's like a big upheaval, isn't it? It's you know, if you have a car, you can get in with your shorts on, your flip-flops on. A motorbike, it's like you're an astronaut or something, and you're only nipping down the road for some milk. Do you know what I mean? So,
But does it annoy you having to put shoes on every day, and underpants, and a vest, and a, I don't know,
no, but once they're on, I'm not carrying them. They're on me. If I had to then take the shorts off for whatever reason and walk around holding them, I'd go, oh, I can't be bothered. I don't like holding a bag. I don't like bags. We carry too much around with us now. I don't like carrying stuff. It's just a hassle, isn't it?
It's just endless things he doesn't want to do, he doesn't like doing. He's like carrying bags. Who the hell has a gripe about carrying bags? Why is that a concern?
Because it's stuff that's on
you. I love the way that he wouldn't mind having a nail going out of his fucking head, but he doesn't want to carry a bag.
What's good with it is, everybody's got one of these. And
but it's not going to happen, Carl.
And the most important thing in your body, apart from the heart, is your brain. So protect that, not the toes. The toes, we can get by
please,
without the
people.
Toes. But your head's important, isn't it? There's a lot of stuff in your head. And I know all this just after seeing the Body Works thing. I went to see the it's a show on where there's a load of, like, dead bodies and that. And you can see how much stuff's in the body. And there's loads of stuff. There's nothing in there that you don't need. It's all doing stuff. Everything in your body.
We've been telling you that for years.
But you reckon you don't need the toenails?
Yeah, that's on the outside. I'm saying everything that's on the inside of your body, right?
You don't need the appendix.
No, doesn't that depend on what lifestyle you have?
Well, it's a hangover of when we probably ate a lot more cellulose and it's...
Yeah, well, they might come back. Things are always coming back, aren't they? So if people start eating them again...
What about male nipples?
Sort of looks all right, though, doesn't it? Because the chest is quite plain, so with nothing on it, you'd go, oh, what's this? It just balances it out. I think it looks all right. I think it works. So leave it. But what were we talking about?
But wouldn't you rather have maybe a little, like a rib cage around the testicles? Because you get a whack in them and it... Oh.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Not an invention, Carl. It's not an invention and we can't do it, but...
But would you be able to sit down still? Because that's the good thing with them at the moment, is movement. So it sort of works. But don't they say, they said something about testicles, the Body Works thing.
Well, they're on the outside.
Put yours away, Carl. You're not one of the exhibits.
They're on the outside because they have to be a few degrees below body temperature for the, I think, the Sertoli cells to
so work. that's an odd design. That they had to go there, because it is a daft, it's a bit of an odd place to have them.
Where would you suggest?
Probably,
dangling from the throat?
Sort of...
I want to redesign you, right? You can possibly do this now. This is something you can actually do, probably. You could probably have your testicles anywhere. So where would you want them?
You've got a giant forehead nail.
Yeah. You could have that. It probably wouldn't grow, but we could certainly have that
I just mean like, because if all it's about is temperature, you don't want to get them too hot.
Yeah.
Well, they're getting hot down there because you're wearing pants and what have you. Mm. So have them nearer to the outside of the body.
Well, they are near the outside of the body.
No, but we wear pants over them.
So you wear pants over them because their testicles and polite society suggests that you don't show your testicles.
Yeah, but that's the odd thing, isn't it? That's what's happened somehow, that we've said testicles shouldn't be seen.
Well, then just cut a hole in your trousers. If it's only about, you know, keeping them cool, and because they're too hot, why don't you just hang them out your shorts?
Because there's too many sort of seats that are shared these days, isn't they? But what I'm saying is...
Well, what are you saying? Where would you
put them?
Somewhere like, sort of under the ears. So it sort of just looks like lobes.
So you would redesign your body to have a pair of testicles hanging from your ears?
And when people are sometimes talking, they do sort of mess with their ears and they're always saying, check for lumps. More handy.
Had a late night last night because I stayed up to watch a programme about monkeys.
It's already good!
Of course it is.
It's already good!
Now, before I read on, I mean, is this not some kind of monkey news? Is this not a late return to monkey news?
Well, it's not. It's not that good.
Is it not? Whereas the other monkey news is...
Oh, chimpanzee, that's some more shit!
This is what he says. This is what he gleaned from the programme about monkeys. It sat on a bridge and wanted stuff off people to walk over the bridge.
What?
So it was acting as some kind of toll booth.
This
was
is
it?
Ridiculous.
No, it was a bridge in like the jungle.
Oh, shut the fuck up!
And it's a monkey that sat on a bridge, and a lot of tourists go through the area.
No, it's a monkey who realised that if he sits there, it'll get stuff because it'll look like it's a cute little chimp begging.
No, but every time.
Yeah, because you give a monkey, you give it to, oh, I'm bad as him now. If you give a chimpanzee a banana, and he starts realising that humans have things to give.
Yeah, but it's all
squirrels learn that. If you don't go, oh, you wouldn't say, oh, went to the park, the squirrel's waiting at the gate, you have to give them a toll to go in, they're only going to give them a nuts, they come up to you every time. You fucking idiot.
Went to bed after watching it and fell asleep thinking about it on the bridge right now. It's a bit bad, really, because the monkey should work harder for its food. It made me remember the slug I saw yesterday that was eating bird poo. Nobody would ever help a slug with food like they do with ducks and monkeys. A slug's life is pretty bad. The only time they come out of their den is when it's raining.
Den.
So even their days out are depressing.
It is. Do you know what I mean?
No.
It is like, it's a horrible thing to be, isn't it? A slug.
Nothing talking about what is it like to be a slug.
No, just because like the monkey, even though it's been quite aggressive, everyone was like, oh, give it some water, and it was well like kitted out. It had like, you know, chocolate bars, bottled water, some like, you know, fizzy stuff and all that.
An iPod, it was listening to monkey news.
It could have had one if it wanted one. It was getting away with murder on that bridge. And that's just because it was furry. Yeah, if that was like a blob, like a slug, there's no way people would be that friendly towards it. And it just annoys me how you get this pecking order. For like, no matter what creature you are, favouritism. And that slug was only eating that bird poo because it wasn't being offered stuff.
If it was offered toffees or whatever.
Well, it's just sad, isn't it? It's come to that. That's what its life has come to.
Yeah, but it's not as mollusk like down on its fucking luck.
It didn't live in a big country house and its wife left it the kids when it started hitting the bottle.
And I kind of thought, and look, they do only come out in the rain and it's depressing and it'll probably get killed in a bit. And that was its last meal. I just...
last meal!
But it wouldn't prefer steak and chips, Carl. It doesn't have...
It must like a leaf or a... You know, at the end of the day, it's an insect. They love
leaves. It's not an insect!
Well, it's part of that gang. It's part of that... No, it's part of that...
They hang out together. They hang out together.
Why do you think it's part of that gang?
Because it knocks about in the woods in the same place as a spider does. But what I'm saying is they're eating boring stuff because that is what's...
It's not boring stuff to them. They're not. I have no opinion of it at all. They take in sustenance.
No, but where you are is what you eat. When I'm in London, I'll have beans on toast for lunch. On holiday, what? Tapas? Go on, I'll have a bit. So it's whatever you eat, what's in that area.
Suzanne went off to work and I went to the shop to buy some envelopes. The shop was empty, but the fella behind the counter was on the phone and just kept talking, even though he could see I was waiting. I started to count backwards from 20. When I got to 6, he hung up and served me. I won't use the shop again. Question, why count backwards from 20?
So he's thinking, what's going to happen at 1? If I start counting from 1, he's going, well, let him carry on.
What, out loud?
So, not really loud, but, like, more of a mouth action, so he could see who was doing it. You know, like,
sorry, You just started miming, counting backwards to a man in a shop.
He's on the phone. The yes. shop is empty. Yes. I thought he'd like me custom. He could have served me and stay on the phone. Even though I don't like that, at least he's still doing what you know, he needs to do.
I'd have said, sorry, can I just get these, please?
Yeah. Well, I stood there and I thought, it's annoying me now, my kidney's aching and I started to get a bit of a sweat on. So I thought, right, I'm going to give him 20 seconds and if he hasn't got off the phone, I'm leaving. And when I got to about six, he served me. What's wrong with that? Again,
you are
giving
one
yourself,
of the strangest people.
It's just giving yourself a thing. I could have been stood there for
free.
Ages.
He's one of the strangest people who's free to walk
yeah,
it's
the
about,
streets.
No, I set myself a little target and I thought, I don't want to waste another 30 seconds in here. I'll give him 20. It worked. He served me at six.
But it didn't work. Yeah, but did he do it because you were doing that or did he finish his phone call?
I don't know. I was busy counting.
Looked at what's been going on in the world. There was a human head attached to a seagull's body in a jar.
Is that all it says?
This is the sort of weird stuff that goes on behind surgery doors. I doubt it ever flew, because the head would have been too heavy.
Well, of course it wasn't it didn't happen. It wasn't live.
No, but they try this stuff, don't they? That's like that programme I watch with a
well,
monkey.
Well, who has ever tried to put a human head on a seagull's body?
They've done loads of stuff like that. It's part of us moving on, isn't it? It's
what are you talking about,
I'm not
going
to get into arguing about
well,
science
you're wrong.
Because it's all
don't
behind closed
shit.
Doors. How do you think we can change a heart now from another body? You have to try things out. It's trial and error. All sorts of weird stuff goes on in hospitals, but we let it happen because it's to help us out in the long run, isn't it?
But what are they aiming towards when they're going to find out if you can put a head on a seagull's body? What is that? What are they want to learn and what do they? How do they want to apply that knowledge? A new heart, it is obviously for a reason, it saves a life. Yeah. What is this, to save money on transport? Instead of getting a bus pass, you go, can I put my head on the seagull's body? I go, well, it won't work. Well, try it.
Yeah, but there is odd things like that. Like, I saw a fish the other day, right?
Right.
And honestly, it's the weirdest thing. It was just like a blob with a face. Now, I would never have said, yeah, let that swim about. I'd have killed it from day dot. I would have been get rid of it.
Oh, God! Under what circumstances would you have killed that from day dot?
Oh, I'm just saying, looking at it, I'd say that does not work. And it looked sad. It looked like it didn't want to be about.
Have you got her number? Now, of course, for those of you who have not been keeping abreast of Carl's medical complaints, just brings up the speed, Carl. You had to go into hospital this week. Because previously you'd had...
I've been in and out, honestly, I've been in and out of that hospital, just with kidney problems, really painful and what have you. And,
yeah, he had kidney stones, all right?
No, but seriously.
Monday. Had a bit of a lie-in today, because I have to get up early for my operation tomorrow. Not only have I got to have tubes shoved up me knob, but I also have to get up at 5:50. Suzanne said I could have what I want for my last dinner. It's not your last dinner, you're going for an operation.
Yeah, but you can't take things for granted these days.
Arthur.
I had shepherd's pie and peas. Suzanne made it from scratch. As nice as it was annoying. Because making stuff from scratch means loads of pots, and it's my job to do the washing up. So much as the food was nice, there was loads of pans and that. People who get their last dinner on death row don't have to wash up. Got up at 5:55. You were supposed to be getting up at 5:50 on the other page. You were 5 minutes late getting up.
He's often late.
Often late.
No, just because I needed to have water. Before 6 o'clock, they said, don't have anything after six.
We'll get up at 5:50 then, like you were planned to.
Don't
you're 5 minutes sleeping.
Doesn't take 10 minutes to have water, though, does it?
Well, why did you say 5:50 in the first
because
place?
Because then it tricks me head, doesn't it? Going, oh, I had an extra 5 minutes.
Tricks me head. Because then it tricks me head.
It. Got to the hospital and had to wait in the waiting room. There was another 9 people in there waiting to be sorted. I got called in. They sat me on a bed and took all my details down. 5 minutes later, I'd been knocked out. I got woke up when they were ripping a pipe out of my throat. I felt more rough this time. The doctor came to see me and said he couldn't find a stone, so I must have passed it. I said, are you sure? He said, yeah, we filled your kidney with water and expanded it, and there was no hiding place. I sat in the recovery room for an hour while they found me a bed. One of the fellows who was sat in the room with me this morning got wheeled in. They couldn't wake him up. All the nurses were laughing because he didn't want to wake up. I bet they were laughing at me when I was in the theatre. Someone told me they totally strip you when they're operating. I would have looked like the alien on the Boswell incident.
Boswell!